Hey there, geology enthusiasts out there. You might have noticed, and probably didn't care, that I missed my release date for the last video because I'm out here in West Virginia, where there is absolutely no connectivity whatsoever. But I did want to just go ahead and make a little bonus episode just for that reason of missing my last one. And I just want to talk about something I noticed while I was out here was bumblebees flying around. And it recalled to me that back in the old days when I was young, it used to be said that science can't explain how bumblebees fly. Look it up, you'll find that one still being used today. Science can't explain why bumblebees fly. Well, since that time of my youth, physicists have figured out exactly how bumblebees fly. We know how now. So, in a sense, it's kind of odd that we think back and say, before we said science can't explain, and now we say science can explain. So, my thought was that perhaps it is always wrong for us, when dealing with natural phenomenon not puffed up by the sensuous mind, but we're looking at natural phenomenon, that we would say, science can't explain is the wrong way to talk about this. It's not that science can't explain how a bumblebee flies. Science can't explain how love exists, or altruism, or why the sun rises. All those things are within the natural realm, and science ultimately can explain. So if you have a phenomenon in the natural world that is currently not explained by science, I propose that we stop saying that science can't explain it, and say science wants to explain it. Science yearns to explain it. And that's the great thing about science. We never say we have the ultimate truth. We yearn for it. And though we can't explain something now, it doesn't mean that we can't explain it later. So I hope that you enjoy that little side bit of what I think about science and what we can explain and what we can't. Thank you very much.